Often I get a question, how to build spoken English, how to get better in terms of spoken English. And I must have tried this with good number of students, and it's a simplified practical approach through my research, how to build your spoken English. Let's deep dive and understand as to how we can get confident of speaking English. If you all are ready, here I go. According to me, to master English language, you need to, any language for that matter, if you are trying to see yourself, how you have mastered your own vernacular, you would definitely get scientific, rather get logical of how you have mastered your own vernacular language. You think in your own language, search for the vocabulary and take that vocabulary into account and immediately get reminded of those words and phrase a sentence and immediately do it. And since you have been doing it for quite some time, you have mastered it as second nature. So when it comes to English language, the rule is simple. To master English language, you just need to think in that language first. And what is that language? English. So search for words and build vocabulary. Now, when you have built vocabulary, new words, lot of new words in your kitty, and you're trying to recollect, what you'll do with those words? You will definitely take the help of those words and frame sentences. So phrasing simple sentences out of the vocabulary that you have learned is what will help you to think in that particular language. And when you have done this, what you need to do is start conversing. Small talks, talking to strangers, building your tempo is what I mean when I say start conversing. And do it naturally. When the child starts speaking a language, it always starts with ta, ba, ka, cha, pa, right? All those letters, not even words. When it comes to learning from letters to word, you graduate. And then when you are evolving, you will definitely see yourself surprisingly that you have learned so many words and you have mastered how to phrase it in the sentence and start conversing with people. Only thing here is you need to be child to express, to communicate to anybody who comes across. And I give you a hint here, I drop you a hint here, let it be the strangers. In case if you are undergraduate, if you are still a school goer or a junior college goer, I think you need to take and help from the stranger. Strangers are the best people to converse with, and they will never mind whether you're speaking naturally or not. Even if you pick up an accent or copying someone, I think they'll never mind because they are seeing you for the first time. So how to master English language? Just dropping a hint from my research. Now, how do you take in help of building vocabulary? One word substitution will help you a lot. What does this mean is nothing but synonyms. If you know what is the meaning of audience, I've jotted down few words right from A to Z. If you take everyday help of coming across one new word, jot it down, know the meaning of it, and maybe try to exercise that particular word in the following day or in days to come. But when you're doing it, do it with a very, very conscious mind. Now, to form a good habit, it takes time. So if you're doing it consciously, the good habits will be converted very, very soon. So take and help of this one word substitution with a meaning, which is also called as synonym. Audience, altruist, atheist, anthropologist, and you have the list right from A to Z, which I have put it in the slide, just to help you to understand that one word substitution is nothing but synonym. So take every new word into account, maybe maintain a diary. How will you remember? If you put to your memory, the chances are very many that you will forget. But if you are writing it somewhere and again going back to the diary, if you have not used that word, you definitely remember that, recall it, and maybe express it at one point or the other when you are interacting with strangers. So playing with words is fun while you learn. So fun while you learn is what is my idea of mastering English language. So reading or listening, identify new words, write it in your notebook. Synonym, find one similar meaning of that word and write it. If you know the synonym, meaning similar meaning of that word, then you should also be knowing the antonym, which is the meaning opposite word to that particular word. And if you have come across synonym, similar meaning, antonym, opposite meaning, let's also know homophones. Word sounding similar to either synonym or antonym. And homonyms, same words with same spelling, but they rhyme the same, but they are used differently. So what I'm asking you is, whenever you're coming across any new word, whether it you are listening to it through some audio or audio visual, or you are reading, please maintain a notebook, write it there. Try to find out a meaning of that word, synonym. Try to find the opposite of it, the antonym. Try to find a homophone, which is a word sounding similar to it. And if you are able to bring about three different words from one word, that means that one word is giving you four words. So a power of one word will give you four more words put together as an exercise, and over a period of, let's say, 200 days, you would be able to 200 days. That means if you are practicing it, making it as a habit and trying to learn one new word, let's say practically 1 month, you'd be able to learn 30 into 4, 3 fours are 12, 120 words. The magic of doing this exercise is actually landing you to remember 120 words. And let's say if you're practicing every week some or the other words, practically 50% of it, 50 to 60 words is what you can master it in one particular month. See the amount of vocabulary that you are adding to your kitty, to your memory, and see the amount of word that you are getting known by now. It's a fantastic exercise, and it is all practical. It is nothing theoretical, and that's the reason I have laid down something for you all. What is that? I have done this exercise on this slide. Get scientific. I have done this exercise on this slide. What I have done is I have put a word: achieve, idle, afraid, ancient, arrive, arrogant. Likewise, from A to C to A to B to C and D and so on and so forth, you can go to Z. Till the exercise does not meet Z, you need to keep practicing. And what I have done is I have found a word achieve. Achieve means something that you have achieved, and the opposite of achieve is when you have not achieved, maybe failed. And what is the similar meaning to fail is detained or unsuccessful. A simple meaning is unsuccessful. And what is that which matches the antonym, one word called as fail, is maybe frail or fell, right? It is called as homophone. A word which is similar sounding to one of the word that you have picked up from the word itself or the antonym or the synonym. So that's how you are able to collect four words out of one word. So achieve, fail, unsuccessful and frail is something that I've picked up from doing one word achieve, and maybe build four different words. Likewise, if you go and build up your vocabulary every day, every single day, I'm sure that you'd march to so many, you'll come across so many new words, and you'll build your vocabulary like it. Not only this, you are exercising your mind to think of a similar word, meaning of it, opposite meaning, homophones, and this is a practical exercise which will get into a fun game where your learning becomes very, very stronger, very pragmatic. And this is what I have to tell you. Now, this is an exercise which I have done with so many students of mine. I must have taught not less than 15,000 students for past 1 year, and I've done it online. And this is what the approach I've taken, and I've asked them to do it. And what they have done is a remarkable, remarkable thing. Now, let me also give you, after homophones, what is homonym? Now, let's say homonyms are the words that have a same spelling, but they are pronounced same, same spelling, same diction, but have a different meaning. For example, I have jotted down few words which are similar spelling, similar pronunciation, but they are used differently. That's the reason they are called as homonym. For example, I've taken the first example is address, which means the manner of speaking to another. You address, the speaker addressing a gathering. And the second is the address, which is your locational address, where you are living, right? So the address can be two meaning, but they are the same spelling and the same pronunciation. Arm. Arm is the second example, which explains to you a body part, and arm is also a division of the company. Division of the defense has three arms, right? Army, Navy, and Air Force. Third example that we can take is bat, an implement used to hit a ball, which we all know, very popular sport called as cricket. And the another bat is an animal, a nocturnal flying mammal, right? And likewise, you can build a homonym with bear, book, bright, cave, so on so forth. So our exercise is not getting restricted only to synonym, antonym, or homophones, but it is also going beyond to homonym. How you'll build your vocabulary? So the second exercise is homonym. The third exercise will be idioms and phrases. How many times we have taken the help of idiom or a phrase or a proverb and explained the entire story? So these idioms or phrases or proverbs, they are extremely common in everyday conversation. But only if you see it consciously, interpret it consciously, and maybe take a clue and maybe exercise to yourself. So idioms, phrases, and proverbs, they are very easy to identify and maybe exhibit. If you have imbibed it, you can exhibit it subtly. You will hear them in movies, a lot of English movies if you see, or TV shows that you see. I mean, I have found that today's generation are also fond of yesteryear's great English classical serial called as Friends. And while they speak to each other, the characters, they have a lot of laughter after it. And those laughter can also have a humor angle. So along with idioms and phrases and proverbs that you possibly spot or hear or listen to, I think the humor angle is also getting chiseled out. So maybe take a clue from that. And maybe if you are listening to them very closely, you can sound like the native speaker yourself. So what I've done is I've also listed down few idioms, meaning of it and the usage of it. So let's try to look at few examples. A blessing in disguise is a very common idiom or a phrase or a proverb that we use, right? And what it means is a good thing that seemed bad at first sight. Simple meaning, and you can use this as a part of the sentence. How you can use it? My God, I've stepped out of from my home to look for something like this, and you were a blessing in disguise. You have it with you. Now I think it will be of a great help to me, right? A dime a dozen, the second example, means something common, right? Which you can use it as a part of a sentence, something common, right? Beat around the bush, avoid saying what you mean, usually because it is uncomfortable. So don't beat around the bush. Come straight away to the point is what I think you should be very, very clear with. You can use as a part of the sentence. What you can use by itself is better late than never. You have arrived, but you have arrived a little late. Better to arrive late than not to come at all. That's what it means. And you can use it by itself. So there are many idioms that I've jotted down in this particular slide just for your understanding that idioms and phrases can be used by themselves or as a part in a sentence, of course knowing the meaning of it. So if you are developing your synonym, antonym and homophone along with homonym, idioms and phrases would also add on to do this particular exercise of building your vocabulary and maybe consolidate your vocabulary. So taking a clue from the first slide to here, where we have reached till homonym or idioms and phrases, I would only say that this is a fantastic exercise of knowing one word, writing in a notebook, having its synonym, antonym, homophone, coming to homonym, right, and also learning idioms and phrases and proverbs where they can be used. I think you just need to practice. How will you practice it if you do not have your friends or maybe strangers, and if you're not comfortable doing it, maybe practice it online. There are a lot of online tests at your help. Just Google it out and ask for synonym. There would be a lot of online tests. Go for it. Try and do it at a regular interval. So when you practice it, do it online. Do it very regularly, maybe once a week, or if you are not very comfortable every day, or maybe alternate day, or once in 3 days, do it, let's say, every week. Pick up a synonym or an antonym or a homophone or a homonym or maybe idioms and phrases and proverbs and do it at a regular interval. I think your practice would be most subtle, right? Practice it with strangers. I've dropped this hint in my first particular slide itself. Strangers are actually the great bouncing boats. They'll always help you. They'll always be there, standing, giving you that support system in case if you are able to find few strangers for yourself, and you can always step out from your home and you can always find strangers you are meeting for the first time. So online test, regular intervals of your online test and practicing it with strangers will definitely help your, give some kind of a concrete shape to your vocabulary which you are learning at your home and stepping out and doing it with a stranger. So there is no magic, there is only this eighth wonder: practice, practice and practice. So if I say this, where I mean the first practice, doing online test, the second practice, do it regular interval, take this test and practice the third time when you step out from your home with the strangers. I'm sure you'd be able to do it and master any language for that matter. Spoken English or English is just a language, it is never a science of a brilliance. So I would only say, happy building vocabulary. Mind you, if you have a good vocabulary back of your memory, you'd be able to shape and phrase and frame and construct good sentences. Start with simple sentences, and when you are able to master it, I'm very sure grammar is something which is taking a back seat. How you will master it? You can master it very soon by taking a help of this pragmatic approach.